Joe Klatt, the voice of college football on our network. All right, Klattster.
What's up?
Usually you and I argue. There's always got to be something I disagree with. So can we both agree with this? Alabama's the best team in the country.
Yes.
Okay. Who is the second best team in the country?
Clemson.
All right, we agree on that.
Yeah.
All right, who's the third best team in the country?
I mean, I would say Michigan right now.
Now that Notre Dame beat them.
Yeah, I mean, that was a long time ago. Michigan's playing better football right now. They just beat Penn State basically to death. They just boat raced them. Notre Dame has struggled during this last few weeks. Remember, they struggled against Pitt. They didn't play great against Northwestern. I think they might have some trouble down the stretch here with Syracuse in Yankee Stadium. That's going to be a neutral site game in New York.
What if Michigan and Oklahoma went out? Who would you put in?
Between the two?
Yeah.
I would put Michigan ahead of Oklahoma.
What if Notre Dame and Oklahoma went out? Who would you put in?
Well, Notre Dame, because they are undefeated. I think Notre Dame with one loss would lose an argument to either Michigan or Oklahoma. Georgia, I think, is going to get a second loss to Alabama. So I think what you're waiting for, if you're Oklahoma or anybody that's trying to get into the top four, you're waiting for the Ohio State-Michigan game and the Syracuse-Notre Dame game. I don't even think Alabama-Georgia is going to be that much of a contest. When you model it out, okay, so I do this thing where it's called plus-minus.
Yeah.
Okay, what do you, on average, give up versus what the opposing team averages, okay? And Alabama basically gives up about 15 less points than what you average offensively. That's what they do as a defense. And then if you were to do that same model out with Georgia, what you would get is about a 16-point game between Georgia and Alabama. Two touchdowns. So I don't think Alabama's going to lose. And even if they do, there's argument that they would get into that top four.
Oh, I'd put them in.
So Ohio State and Syracuse is everybody's best bet. If you're looking for an in, you know, maybe it's West Virginia that wins a couple of games there at the end, or Washington State that's looking for a prayer. I think those are the only two games that are going to shake up this top four is Syracuse, Notre Dame, and Ohio State, Michigan. Other than that, Alabama, Clemson, they should send them invites right now. I think those two teams are in the playoff.
I think you're right. I think Alabama, and by the way, I don't buy this Alabama could beat an NFL team. I don't think they couldn't beat the best Canadian Football League team. Clemson. Ooh. Hey,
maybe
Pierre St. John, left tackle for the Argonauts, is quite a player. Sacre bleu. Okay, all I'm saying is this. When I watch Clemson and I watch Bama, a bunch of Sunday guys, I look at those two teams. Alabama comes in being told they're the best team ever. No losses. Clemson's playing with house money. Dabo Sweeney and that staff know exactly what Alabama does. I think Clemson's got a real – but you do that plus-minus thing you do.
Yeah, when I put them into that kind of, like, equation, it spits out a three-point game.
Okay.
Which is the closest game that Alabama would have. They would be a two-touchdown favorite against everybody in the country
let's
or
do that.
More.
And
Clemson's the only one that spits out basically a three-point game.
Okay, so you do this. This is the Klatt computer at home.
Yeah.
It's your washer and dryer.
It's the plus-minus,
okay,
right? How much do you score versus what your opponent is constantly giving
Alabama
up?
Against Notre Dame, what's the spread?
Oh, gosh, it would be about 20.
Alabama-Michigan.
It would be 14, right at the two-touchdown mark.
Alabama-Oklahoma.
It would be 16, and it would be right now what I have it is at 50 to 34.
Alabama-Georgia.
It's about 17 right now.
And Alabama-Clemson.
3.
Okay. So don't tell me they're better than the Raiders. Is Clemson better than the Raiders?
No,
it's ridiculous.
No, they're not. Clemson has the only shot. Remember now, Clemson is balanced, and I think that's what Alabama could potentially struggle with. Clemson has the number 4 scoring offense, the number 4 scoring defense, and this is a team right now that's leading the country in rushing yards per play against and rushing yards per play for. So they're winning the line of scrimmage at all times, running the football and stopping the run. They do it better than anybody in the country on a per-play basis. That's a huge feather in their cap. And then you look at what they're doing against an egregiously bad ACC right now. But what are they doing? What they're supposed to be doing.
You crushing
know their last
people.
4 games, they've won by an average of 51 points. By an average of 51 points over a 4-game stretch. They're playing unbelievably well right now.
Okay, let me give credit to somebody. Now, we both like Harbaugh.
Yep.
Okay, and when all these critics of Harbaugh were out there, there were two right-thinking Americans.
Two
in the whole world.
Everyone
was out on Harbaugh.
Okay. On the planet.
And so
they were flying banners
Jim,
over the stadium.
Jim was out on Jim, except for us.
Yeah, a couple of winners
That's
here.
That's right.
Okay, let me say something. Brian Kelly, private school. Cold, rural, no JCs, religious overtones, academically hard, Notre Dame winning 11 games to me is more impressive than Bama winning the title. I'm dead serious.
Interesting. I think he's done a great job. A great job. Going undefeated is really hard.
By the way, they play out of conference. Michigan, Stanford, NFL players on those teams.
And then they have the ACC relationship, and the ACC is historically bad this year. I mean, historically bad.
Let's give Kelly some love.
Kelly is doing a great job, and he's also made a couple of decisions this year that have changed the course of their season. Benching Brandon Wimbush and going with Ian Book has improved them 15 points per game. 15 points per game. That's just a coaching decision. They're also doing a lot of really good things on the ground, even minus their best offense of linemen who got injured earlier this year, and two guys that were in the first round last year, McGlinchey and Quentin Nelson. So they're all of a sudden down three offensive linemen from a year ago, and guess what they're still doing? Running the ball. They can play really solid defense with Jerry Tillery. I like Notre Dame a lot. I don't think that they're going to lose, so I think that they're going to go to the playoff. I think the best bet for somebody else, like OU, if you're waiting for Notre Dame to lose, I think their best bet to lose is probably Syracuse in Yankee Stadium.
Dino Babers, great coach.
And they score a lot of points. They're averaging over 40 points a game, Syracuse is. So maybe if all of a sudden you get a turnover or two and now Notre Dame can't catch up, I think that's the blueprint to beat the Irish.
I like this whole, let's go back to the Klatt, you're like an odds maker.
Yeah, it's a plus-minus system. So basically I have this huge, and
Did you create it?
Actually, yes, along with one of our guys here named Steve Owens, who does a great job in helping me in research. And what we do is basically we plug in, on average, so here's a for instance. Let's say Oklahoma scores 50 points on you and you on average give up 25.
Okay.
Well, then they get a plus 25 value for that game.
Okay.
And then you average out what's your plus minus over the course of the year in scoring offense, scoring defense, total yards, offensive and defense, and then rush and pass. And you can get a good sense of what teams are dominant in what areas and then what matchups are bad for certain teams. Here's the things that you're going to see. Oklahoma is the best offensive team in the country, by all those plus-minus statistics. They're also really bad on defense.
Awful.
Really bad on defense. Alabama and Clemson are the only two that are consistently strong across the board in every category. Even Michigan, who I think is a great team, will have a plus or minus 96th category. You know, they're 96th in the country in plus-minus passing yards per game. Well, that's not very good. So they're basically averaging 50 yards less per game throwing the ball than what their opponent averages giving up. That's not very good.
Yeah.
So that plus or minus will give
that's
you
why I think Michigan would get
score outcome.
I think
like
Michigan would get boat raced by Alabama. I don't love their offense.
I think they would get beat by 14 points because that's what my model says.
Well, I got a supermodel at home.
Whoa.
And she says 20.
You know what else you got?
A book.
A book.
By the way, Dabo Sweeney doesn't like me.
Joy.
Can we have Dabo?
Why? Why does Dabo not like you?
At the end of the day, we left no doubt tonight. You know, we wanted to play Alabama because now y'all got to change your stories. You got to change the narrative. Y'all got to mix it up. You know, the guy that called us a fraud, ask Alabama if we're a fraud, was his name Colin Cowherd. Ask him, I don't never met him, don't know him. Ask him if
Alabama. Wait, a fraud or a frog?
Joel Klatt.
Come on, you're not going to hold a grudge over that. That was 2 years ago.
He's a good dude, sir.
He's decent.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show. Also, be sure to check out more of the best clips from The Herd or go watch a few segments from other shows on FS1.